Hey, what's up, guys? This is Gabriel Lemaine, a.k.a. Z-Slash, here at Brooklyn Book Fair 2014, and I'm here with...
Terence Hawkins.
Yes, Terence Hawkins is the author of American Neolithic. Tell us a little bit about the world of American Neolithic, would you?
It's kind of a moving target dystopian near very near future. It's set a year from now, whenever now happens to be, after a dirty bomb scare has terrified the country into giving up its last civil liberties through the passage of the Patriot Amendments. Into this world comes a Neanderthal, a member of the last surviving band of Neanderthals who live on the Lower East Side. Mm-hmm. His name is Bling Bling, and he is the last literate Neanderthal. So he's taught himself to read and write, mm-hmm. and he's sent out into the world by his tribe to earn money for Starbucks and batteries, because that's essential to their religious practices. Mm-hmm. So eventually he winds up getting a job in the Astor Place Buzzcut Palace, sweeping up hair. He falls in with a hip-hop group and winds up getting framed for a murder. And we take it from there.
So pretty much like it's pretty much very, very close to what it is now, with the exception of, is this Neanderthal going to hit the top of the charts?
Sadly, he doesn't. Sadly, he does not. He actually winds up getting a public access TV show for a little while, but that doesn't work out for him.
Not even YouTube is ready for Neanderthal beats?
Not even YouTube. I know, it's heartbreaking.
So what kind of themes do you try to explore in American Neolithic?
Well, one of the major themes, of course, is our willingness to surrender our civil liberties whenever we feel threatened by somebody from the outside.
What do you mean? Like, we're not totally going to get amped up to fight an enemy again, like really, really soon?
Yeah, unless it happens to be named ISIS or ISIL or any other acronym you can think of.
Bad guys need acronyms.
Bad guys need acronyms, exactly. But in any event, immediately, the other major theme is an exploration of why it is we're so willing to treat people different from ourselves as being completely other than human. And when I started this book, it wasn't clear yet that humans and Neanderthals had existed at the same time. Mm-hmm. Subsequently, of course, it became clear that not only did we, but modern European Americans carry Neanderthal genes. Mm-hmm. So science kind of cooperated with me in that respect. I'm pretty happy about that. Mm-hmm. And so did politics, for that matter.
So what are some of the other books that you've written as well?
My other book is called The Rage of Achilles. It's a novelization of the Iliad in mm-hmm. prose. So that came out in 2009. And it's still widely available, I'm happy to say.
Is this your first foray into speculative fiction?
Actually, no. When I was 14 to 16 years old, I wrote a science fiction novel that I typed on an old Royal Manual upright. And it was really, I can't really call it writing. It was really more of an exercise in plagiarism because I basically just ran together every good idea I could pick out of any other book. I think it was in my mother's closet for a while, but it's finally disappeared, and I'm happy about that. Yeah. I don't ever want it to see the light of day.
Well, thanks very much for talking with me.
My pleasure. Take
All
it
right.
easy.
So where can people find American Neolithic?
American Neolithic can be ordered from its publisher's website, CNR Press. It can also be found on Amazon and Barnes & Noble.
Okay.
And, of course, if anybody's around, here at the Brooklyn Book Fair.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
This is E-Slash, signing off.